CloudEndure provides disaster recovery for any application. In this demo, we'll walk you through how to launch an up-to-date, fully functioning copy of your machines in minutes. To get started, we have logged into the CloudEndure console. This drop-down menu provides access to all your CloudEndure projects. We will now show an on-premises to AWS disaster recovery project. First, we set the replication settings on the Setup and Info page. For this demo, I've selected on-premises as my source infrastructure, which is shown as Other Infrastructure. For my target infrastructure, I've selected AWS US East Ohio. Here is the Machines page where you can track the data replication status of your machines. We already have a WordPress application server in sync, which is one part of a two-tier application. Now we'll add a MySQL machine, which is the database server associated with this application. Instructions for installing the CloudEndure agent on Windows or Linux machines can be found through the Help menu. Installing this lightweight agent has no system impact and does not require a reboot. For large-scale projects, you can perform installation using a CLI or any mass software distribution tool. Back on the Machines page, we can check the replication status of the new machine. To get a drill down of the replication process, click on the machine name. The initial sync of a new machine happens entirely in the background, with no performance impact and no downtime. Replication begins with a sequence of checkpoints to establish connectivity between the CloudEndure agent, the CloudEndure console, and your target infrastructure. After the initial sync, CloudEndure only needs to synchronize the deltas, which we do using block-level continuous replication. This is how we enable sub-second RPOs. Now let's take a look at the machine's blueprint. Here you can define exactly how you want your target machines to be launched, including machine type, target subnet, private IP, and other settings. Note that the options shown vary depending on the target infrastructure and the services enabled. As you can see, the initial sync of this machine is complete, and the new machine is in continuous data protection mode. The time it takes to complete the initial sync depends on your total bandwidth and latency and whether your connection is dedicated for replication. Both applications are now synced. To demonstrate CloudEndure's continuous data replication, we'll make changes on the web layer that will commit to the MySQL backend database. CloudEndure will then immediately replicate the changed data. Now let's jump over to the live WordPress blog. We'll create a new post with the current time so that we can check that the target machines are spun up with the most recent version of the blog. The new post is now published. In the background, the CloudEndure agent has already recognized the write I/O operations, captured the blocks, and replicated them asynchronously into a staging area in AWS US East Ohio. The low-cost staging area keeps data in sync up to the last second while eliminating the need for duplicate resources, saving our customers 80% or more on disaster recovery. Now let's look at how to launch target machines. For disaster recovery projects, you can launch a target machine by checking the box to the left of each machine and selecting Test Mode or Recovery Mode under the Launch Target Machines menu. For the demo, we will select Test Mode. We suggest that you perform regular tests on your machines as part of your disaster recovery strategy. In the event of a disaster, select Recovery Mode. Click Next, then select the recovery point for the machine. Here you can choose to spin up the latest version of a machine or a previous version. This point-in-time recovery capability is critical to preventing data loss due to database corruption, accidental system changes, ransomware, or other malicious attacks on your environment. When I click Continue with Launch, the machines will be launched and will be automatically converted to an AWS running instance. To keep this demo short, we fast-forwarded the launch of the target machines, but the actual time it took was around 2 minutes. During these 2 minutes, CloudEndure's automated orchestration engine took the latest snapshot of the source servers and started creating the target cloud resources. It then orchestrated the machine conversion process in order to launch fully functional workloads in AWS. This process includes making bootloader changes, injecting hypervisor drivers, and installing any cloud tools that may be needed. Now let's verify that the launch target machines are in fact identical to the source machines. We can get the IP address of the application server by clicking on it and navigating to the Target tab. As you can see, the newly spun up target machines include the changes that we made on the source machine right before launching the test. The test was indeed successful, and the machines are now ready to fail over in the event of a disaster. After the disaster is over, the machines can be failed back to your source. Once testing is completed, CloudEndure allows users to delete the target machines that were created during the test in order to free up resources in the target subnet. This concludes our disaster recovery demo. We hope this demo helped you understand our solution and look forward to hearing from you.